I would like to thank you very much, Dr. Mavilia, for inviting me. The participants of this conference are highly qualified experts and scientists, and I am very honored to have the possibility to say a few words as a representative of our civil society initiative, Grannies Against the Extreme Right, and how ethics and digitalization is influencing as well our work. As you mentioned, we Grannies Against the Extreme Right, or as we are called in Germany, Omas gegen Rechts, are a civil society initiative. It was founded originally in Austria in November 2017 by Monika Salzer. In response to the coalition of the Austrian People's Party and the Freedom Party of Austria. On January 27, 2018, just 2 months later, Anna Ohnweiler read on social media a hateful, extremely anti-feminist remark written by an Austrian right-wing extremist who belonged to the so-called Identitären group. The posting reminded her as well on ideas on the Nazis about useless lives and on extreme right-wing political positioning gaining a certain popularity as well in Germany. She was so angry that she sat down and created the Facebook group Omas gegen Rechts in Germany. So actually, the foundation of our initiative was triggered by a hateful posting on social media. And also, we are mostly elderly women, and certainly by far less familiar than the young generation or the experts we just heard with digital possibilities. We used a Facebook group to build up our initiative in Germany. Meanwhile, this initiative has over 100 regional groups in Germany and about 15,000 members. In 2020, an association was founded to give the initiative a legal backing. However, the initiative itself are independent in their way of acting. What are our goals and objectives? As you mentioned, violent right extremism has become more and more dangerous in recent years. Also, most of us were born after the Second World War. We still felt as children the terrible consequences of these horrible times and the war. We had asked our parents and grandparents, why did you not speak up when you still had the possibility? We never want our grandchildren to ask us the same question. That is why we raise our voice against the poison of nationalism, discrimination, racism, anti-Semitism, and hate, but for human rights, for solidarity, for the European Union, and for democracy. We stand for democracy, and also we call ourselves against the far right. We deny any kind of extremism, as well radical left one. And we are not affiliated with any political party. We do not want a revolution, but we strongly demand reforms. We are demanding that Article 1 of our Grundgesetz, our constitutional law, to be respected. That means no person is allowed to be disadvantaged because of their origin, skin color, gender, or sexual identity. But we are as well supporting the young people and Fridays for Future movement. And we want to support them in fighting the climate crisis. And we engage ourselves for more social equality and better education. How are we raising our voice? Well, we are grandmas, and many of our actions are not digital. We are demonstrating. We are organizing events in remembrance of the victims of the terror of the regime, the so-called Third Reich under Hitler, and very sadly, meanwhile, as well in remembrance of victims of violent right-wing extremism nowadays. We're having information desks in the cities. We're writing petitions, and we wrote a book titled kind of Resolutely Defend Democracy, Together Push Back the AfD. We are holding rhetorical seminars as well for young people, how to act and speak out against racist behavior and speech, how to position themselves without putting yourself in physical danger. And now we plan to read, like grandmas do, to small children out of books that will offer them an open, tolerant approach to people that may not all look like them and might have different traditions. How do we use digital media? Well, for information of the public, we do have websites, Facebook sites, and YouTube videos. For internal information about racist or anti-democratic fascist happenings, or for our planned activities and actions, we are using Facebook groups, private ones, WhatsApp, instant messenger. And for the grandmas that are not yet using social media, we are informing them by email. We position ourselves strongly against right-wing extremism, against hate and violence. And also some of the actions and words of the extreme right make us very angry. We do have the strong ethical principle never to use hateful words ourselves. The corona pandemic has in many aspects limited our activities, but it certainly helped us to improve our skills concerning digitalization. Before corona, we only met in person. Now, we baby boomers are Zooming almost daily. Zoom, Jitsi, WebEx, and so on have become part of our regular daily life. So we are able to meet online, plan actions against right-wing extremism for democracy, even in times of the pandemic situation. Zoom and so on have notably increased our network possibilities. Amongst our regional initiatives, we are meeting now regularly on Zoom and are planning coordinated actions all over Germany. This helped a lot to increase our awareness in public. But it has increased as well the network possibilities with other initiatives or institutions fighting for the same cause as we do. Combined, we are stronger against violent right-wing extremism. Naturally, digitalization is not without danger. Populists and extremists are using it to spread conspiracy ideology, to increase fear, and to split and polarize our society further. We are aware of the danger of digital violence, such as hate speech, cyber mobbing, and shitstorms, and we do face some of it. This danger is recognized finally as well by politicians, and initiatives initiated by the European Council, such as the No Hate Speech Movement, are very important and very helpful. It is now applicable in many European countries. It is much easier to write a hateful remark on social media than telling it to a person face by face. And we are well aware that radicalization in social media can even lead to murder. But civil society initiatives, such as Grannies Against the Extreme Right, that engage themselves for human rights, for the dignity of all human beings, must not let themselves get intimidated and stay engaged though that the cyberspace can serve too, as well being for the humans. Okay, thank you very much. It was not so scientific than the other ones. It was just a practical thing, how we are acting.
Thank you. We need this combination of the research, researchers and the people committed with all this kind of organization and campaigns. So your presentation has been really appreciated. And thank you so much for your work. I know your presence at demonstration and against far right is very, very strong. So thank you so much for everything.
Thank you for having me once again.